हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू केआर लक्कम सीबीएसई स्कूल मुदोल ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस
पाइथागोरस थ्योरम।
सो टुडे आई विल डिस्कस प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन पाइथागोरस थ्योरम। मींस आई विल स्टार्ट डिस्कशन ऑफ
एक्सरसाइज 6.5।
सो हियर इन एक्सरसाइज 6.5 प्रॉब्लम नंबर 1, व्हाट दे आर गिवन हियर, sides of triangles are given below. They are given sides of the triangles. Determine which of them are right angles. So we have to determine which of them are right triangles. In case of a right triangle, write the length of its hypotenuse. They are given here length of the sides, and we have to check whether these are right angle triangle or not. If it is right angle triangle, then we have to mention hypotenuse. So to check whether these sides are of the right angle triangle or not, what we will use? We will use Pythagoras theorem only. So here in first problem, they have given again four problems here. In first problem, 7 cm, 24 cm, and 25 cm they have given here. So 7 cm means 7 square, 7 square means what you will get? 49 plus 24, 24 means what you will get? 24 square means 576 is the answer. 24 square means 576, 24 square. Like that only. 25 square means what you will get? 625. So now we have to check whether 49 plus 576 is equals to 625 or not. So here 576 plus 49 means 9 plus 6 15, 7 plus 4 11, 11 plus 1 12, 5 plus 1 6, therefore 625. 49 plus 576 is equals to 625. So it is correct. Now we can write that this is 49 means 7 square plus 576 means 24 square equals to 625 means 25 square. Therefore, what you got here? AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Means it holds good for Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, it is right angle triangle. Therefore, what you can write here? It is right angle triangle or right triangle. And again, what they are given here? If it is right triangle, we have to mention hypotenuse of that triangle. What is the hypotenuse here? 25 cm is the hypotenuse. You know, according to the Pythagoras theorem, the square of sums of the two sides is equal to the square of the hypotenuse. Therefore, here 25 is the length, 25 cm. Here I will write. Therefore, length of hypotenuse. Length of hypotenuse is equal to how much? 25 centimeters. So this is the first problem in first main. So now I will consider another one, second. In second problem, what are the values they have given? 3 cm, 8 cm, 3 cm, 8 cm. 6 cm, 3, 8, 6 cm. So here I will consider shortest two sides, means 3, 6 first. After that only I will consider 8 cm, because always hypotenuse has higher length or longest than other two sides. Therefore, first I will consider 3 square plus 6 square is equal to 8 square. So here, first I will consider 3 cm, after that 6 cm, after that 8 cm, because hypotenuse has the longest length in right angle triangle. Therefore, here 3 square means what you will get? 3 square means you will get 9 plus 6 square means what you will get? 6 square means 36 is equal to 8 square means 64. 8 into 8, 64. Now you can check whether 9 plus 36 is equal to 64 or not. So here 36 plus 9 means what you will get? 45. So here this 45 is not equal to 64. Therefore, this 9 plus 36 is not equal to 64. Means here you can write 3 square. 9 means 3 square plus 36 means 6 square is not equal to 8 square, because here 9 plus 36 means what you will get? 45. This is not equal to 64. Therefore, it is not right triangle or right angle triangle. So here it is not right angle triangle, therefore no need to mention hypotenuse. Always hypotenuse is present in right angle triangle only, but it is not right angle triangle, therefore there is no need to mention hypotenuse. So this is the second one. So in first main only, again they have given another two questions, third and fourth. So try to solve those questions also, third and fourth questions, like this only. Those two are similar to first two problems only. Try to solve those problems. Now I will discuss second problem of exercise 6.5 only. So for second problem, this is the diagram we can refer, because what they are given here, PQR, here PQR is triangle, it is a triangle right angled at P. So here right angled at P, P is 90 degree here, and M is point on QR. This M is the point on QR, such that PM, this PM is perpendicular to QR. PM is perpendicular to QR. Show that PM square is equals to QM into MR. So now what they have given here, first I will write given values. PQR is right triangle where angle P is equal to 90 degree, and this PM is perpendicular to QR. PM is perpendicular to QR. We have given this. And we have to prove, what we have to prove here? They are given PM square is equals to PM square equals to QM dot MR. QM dot MR means QM into MR. So now proof. So here to prove this, first I will consider triangle MPR. Here in triangle MPR, so sum of, in this triangle MPR, sum of interior angles equals to how much? 180 degree by angle sum property of triangle. So now we can write here, what we can write, angle MPR. So here first I will consider, let angle MPR is equals to x. Here this angle MPR, this angle as x. Here I will consider angle MPR equals to x. So now I will consider here angle MPR plus angle MRP, angle MRP plus angle PMR, this angle equals to 180 degree by angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property. So now angle MPR is x. We consider angle MPR as x, and we don't know value of angle MRP. So here I will write angle MRP, and angle PMR, how much it is? Angle PMR is 90 degree because this PM is perpendicular to QR. Therefore here we can write in the place of angle PMR, 90 degree equals to 180 degree. So now to calculate angle MRP, what we can do? We can move this 90 degree and x to other side. Therefore angle MRP equals to 180 degree. Now I will move this 90 degree to other side, minus 90 degree, and x to other side, therefore minus x. Here it is plus, when you move to the other side it becomes minus 90, like that. And when you move x to other side it becomes minus x. So now 180 minus 90 means 90 degree. Therefore we can write here, therefore here I will write angle MRP. MRP is equal to 180 minus 90 means how much you will get? 90 degree minus x. 180 minus 90 means 90 minus x. This is considered as 1. So now we got the note, this angle is 90 degree and this angle MRP is 90 degree minus x. And this is considered as angle x. So now I will consider another triangle MPQ. Here I will consider another triangle MPQ in triangle MPQ. Where is the second triangle MPQ? Here MPQ, first I will consider this angle MPQ. Angle MPQ equals to this angle. MPQ means this angle. Here this angle P is 90 degree. We know that angle P is 90 degree, and this angle is X. Means this remaining angle should be 90 minus this x. So here angle MPQ is equal to MPQ. This angle equals to what we can write? Angle RPQ, means this whole angle equals to angle RPQ minus angle MPQ. This angle minus angle MPQ means here RPQ is angle P is 90 degree, angle MPQ is considered as x. Therefore angle MPQ is 90 minus x degree. Sorry,
90 degree minus x. So here we can write 90 degree minus x. And we know that here it is PM is perpendicular to QR, therefore PMQ is 90 degree. Angle PMQ is 90 degree because this PM is perpendicular to QR. Therefore PM is perpendicular to QR here. Now remaining angle is here it is 90 degree. Now remaining angle is Q. MQP angle MQP equals to when you subtract 180 degree minus these two angles, you will get the angle MQP, or you can do it in other way also, means by angle sum property only. Here angle MQP plus angle MQP means this angle plus angle MPQ. MPQ means this angle. Angle MPQ plus angle PMQ. This angle is equals to how much? 180 degree only. Therefore, angle MQP. What is the value? MQP, we have to find out that angle MQP plus MPQ. MPQ means what you will get here? Angle MPQ is equal to 90 degree minus x here. Therefore, 90 degree minus x plus angle PMQ. PMQ means 90 degree. Here it is PM is 90 degree. Here we can write 90 degree is equal to 180 degree. So now what you got here? 90 degree minus x plus 90 degree. Therefore, to calculate angle MQP, I will move all these values to other side. 180 degree. So here minus 90 degree. This is plus x, here it is minus, when you move to other side it becomes plus, therefore plus x. Next it is plus becomes minus 90 degree here. So now 180 degree, here it is minus 90 degree, minus 90 degree, minus into minus plus, therefore we have to add 90 plus 90, how much you will get? 180, and the sign is minus, therefore angle MQP equals to 180 degree minus 180 degree because of 90 90 90 minus 90. Minus 90 means minus into minus plus, therefore we have to add 90 plus 90 means 180. The sign in front of both the values is minus, therefore minus 180 plus x. So now 180 minus 180 means 0 will get, therefore angle MQP is also equal to x. What you got now? Angle MQP is equals to x. So here this angle MPQ, angle MPQ I will consider that as second. This is second. So now we can consider both the triangles, and here we know here it is 90 degree, here also it is 90 degree, this is 90 minus x degree, this is also 90 minus x degree, and here this angle is x, and here we got angle MQP, this is also x. Therefore by angle, these two triangles are similar. So here we can write, I will consider both the triangles in triangle MPR. Triangle MPR and triangle MPQ, this triangle MPQ, what we can write here? So first I will consider this angle. This angle M is 90 degree. PMR, angle PMR equals to angle PMQ, this angle. Angle PMQ. For each angle is 90 degree here. So now again this angle PRM
angle P R M or M P R angle M P R sorry angle MRP, this is considered as 90 minus X. Angle MRP equals to here in this triangle angle MPQ, this is also 90 minus X degree. Angle MPQ, which is equal to 90 minus X degree here from 1 and 2. MRP is also 90 minus X, and here MPQ is also 90 minus X. Therefore, here what you can write here from 1 and 2, these two angles are equal, 90 degree minus X. So now again I will consider these two angles. Here this angle MPR is considered as X, and here angle MQP, this is also X. So X here we got, angle MQP is also X. Therefore we can write angle MPR equals to angle MQP, because both the angles equals to X. Therefore you can write, what you can write here, these two triangles, triangle MPR is similar to triangle MPQ. If these two triangles are similar, then we can write corresponding sides are proportional. We know that when two triangles are similar, we can write corresponding sides which are proportional here. So now directly without observing this triangle, we can write the corresponding sides by what they have given. Two proof. What do I get? Pm square is equal to Qm into Mr, means here I will write Pm divided by Qm, because when you cross multiply, it will go top side of the other side. Therefore, Pm by Qm equals to, here it is Mr, I will write it as same as it is Mr. And here we should get Pm square only. Therefore Mr by Pm means when you cross multiply these values, Pm into Pm square. So when you take this Pm to left hand side, so it becomes Pm into Pm means Pm square, like that only. So here when you take this Pm to other side, so here Pm into Mr. Now, how to consider this? Here Pm, here it is given Pm square, means here first I will consider Pm by Qm. So when you cross multiply, Qm will go top side of the other side. Therefore Pm by Qm and Mr as it is Mr by Pm. Why? Pm into Pm, Pm square, and Qm into Mr, Qm into Mr. Therefore what you can write? Cross multiply. So here I will write final answer. Hence we prove Pm into Pm, Pm square equals to Qm into Mr. Here I will write Qm into Mr. Hence it is proved. See here what we did. They are given this angle P is 90 degree and this Pm is perpendicular to Qr. So we have to prove Pm square is equal to Qm into Mr. To prove this, what we did, first in triangle MPR we consider this angle P as X here. If this is X and this is 90 degree, it becomes 90 degree minus X. So we got the first value here. So in this second triangle MPQ, so this is 90 minus X because it is X and this full angle is 90 degree. Therefore 90 degree minus X here it is, and this is 90 degree because it is perpendicular. And when you calculate by using these two angles of the triangle, we will get this answer as X here. Angle MQP is equal to X. So therefore, three angles are equal here. The three angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal in two triangles. Therefore, by AAA means angle. These two triangles are similar. Therefore, corresponding sides are proportional. When you cross multiply these corresponding sides, you will get answer as Qm square is equal to Qm into Mr. I hope you all are clear with this problem. In next class, I will continue with third problem. Thank you all.